It's the
I believe, I could be wrong, but I believe this is a Thraben University brew. And it's gotten some trophies outside of him as well. It's got a few trophies outside of him. I did tweak the sideboard a little bit. Hopefully I didn't damage it too much. There was like one Fury. And one Fiery Confluence that I cut for more Karn tutorables. I added the Ballista for Karn to grab. Pretty much every time I register Karn and don't have a Ballista in the board, I end up regretting it, is the thing. Is why I did that. And I added the fourth Leyline. Oh, thank you, Alicartez. Alicartez with a background. It's not a Thraben University brew, but Thraben was one of the first people to trophy with it. Sweet. Yeah, thanks for that info. Nice to appropriately credit things. Get to whip out Punishing Fires. I fucking love this Punishing Fire art. I know some people don't like it, but it's like one of my favorite card arts. That expression on the dragon's face. That dragon knew what he did. He's all pleased with himself. There's like a pile of flaming corpses in the background. Yeah, that's so good. Yeah, Blood Sun is not the same thing as Blood Moon. It's got a different thing going on. It's still very, very good against like lands and stuff. It's very good with City of Traders, which is part of how we're going to get up to 6 mana for this Jokulhaups. And then there's, of course, way more Planeswalkers than you usually see in these prison decks, because that's what gets left. That's what gets left behind. I'm gonna play some villagers. They're kind of a mood. That wasn't them. A mood, a vibe. Stay close to the river and cry in the river. Another one of those bands I'm excited to see this weekend. Just keep this hand with the turn two Karn. Well, who else playing Yorion? This hand just like does nothing if they counter the Karn. We're all in here. It's either Death and Taxes or some Dirtle Pile. The Flooded Strand probably applying the Dirtle Pile, huh? I wish there was a red card in the sideboard for this Chrome Mox. Yeah, I got you, Crample. I'm actually not checking any bags, so we can just, like, put you in a box, poke some air holes. He's a cow, at least the 39 months there. Chrome Mox imprint, play second Karn. No bags for a week. Well, I'm bringing carry-on workshops. I'm not a big fan of checking bags in general. Slows you down travel-wise. And then there's the chance of the airline losing your shit. And that chance is increased, like the number of connections you have. I'm just gonna nuke the graveyard and make this Ramenop a little bit less zesty. So now they don't have the wasteland to rebuy. I heard that the carry-on bags are smaller in Europe. Oh, fuck this wasteland. It's an interesting green sun. Uptick on the bridge. I think I'm just gonna pass here. As much as I want to kill this dried armor, I also want to keep my ballista around, I feel. I hate that the Chandra didn't resolve, so we didn't get rid of this excavator a billion years ago. I hate it. opponent very close to getting the arrow back. This is a green sun? Oh, it's just like the natural prime time? Fair enough. I thought they were going to be like putting Yori into hand here. So we're gonna uptick this. We don't want to put a card in our hand right now, because then it would let, like, the Dryad Arbor for attack, for instance. I probably want to kill the Dryad Arbor, huh? And then next turn, we're just gonna downtick for Lattice. I could downtick for Spyglass and aim that Flooded Strand. The odds of that mana matters. Yeah, folk rock, folk metal, fucking stoner rock, psychedelic rock, some blend of those genres, what we're listening to right now. I'm not sure how much the card in the graveyard for Uro matters. I guess I could help them draw a card to answer the bridge right now. That'd be disastrous if they just like ripped a removal spell. God damn it. We were just about to let us lock them. They have this turn. They have this turn to rip. Fair enough. The knight's probably a one-off, but they're also playing Green Sun, right? So it's not just like, it's not just knight that does it, right? It's the knight or a Green Sun Zenith or a prismatic. You know, it's like a bunch of outs there, but we were just trying to fade one turn, you know? Draw a stupid land or something. Or yeah, Karn down. Now I don't have Karn to go get another bridge. Stop punishing fire, how you doing? Make it natural into another bridge. The second Karn like almost fucking works. We're a mana short. Fuck. I guess we still like tutor for Trinisphere. Do they have lethal? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12? No. Jokulhaups? Oh yeah, Jokulhaups would have been sick here, huh? I think they just get to, like, attack, clear all my planeswalkers here, and then next turn, they just, like, chill on the Yorian, and the Yorian can blink bridge for the win. What will you do for yourself? A lot of the cube. A lot of the cube drafts. I was going really hard on Caleb Gannon's cube, and I didn't have time to upload all of them, all of the sweet ones that I thought should be uploaded. But earlier this month, I did render them all. I did save them. And then last night, I uploaded them all to YouTube. So there will be content coming out on that. A video or two every day. If I did it right. Yorian can't blink bridge? No, but it can blink a knight that kills the bridge. We do still have Chandra here. I was pretty impressed with 5-mana Chandra for a few turns that I had it out. It seemed powerful. Punishing Fire on Knight? Yeah, they could do it. Keep it from getting blinked. Maybe that's why they're playing out the Yorian here. If they think that I'm going to be able to blow up the Knight anyway, they might as well get something. Oh, they're not doing Yorian, they're doing Uro, sure. Are we living? Maybe. The opponent's got a lot of time, and they're gonna be able to double wasteland me, and I think they'll get out of this pretty easy. They'll just, like, find a prismatic eventually, and kill, like, the second bridge, and kill me. But we could, like, do runner draws of, like, Walker into Jokulhaups, or that sort of thing. I wonder what my opponent's tank is about here. Weird name for a card? Sweet name for a card. Sandwich tank, getting a sandwich. Yeah, I don't hate it. This is game one, though, and they have 16 minutes on the clock. I mean, you gotta go, but... Oh, we know they have plenty of outs to the bridge. Yeah, like that one, huh? That'll do. Well, that'll do. Gonna take the time to wasteland me? That seems important. So based on the matchup, if I want any of this shit out of the sideboard, I kind of feel like no. I kind of feel like the main deck's about where I want to be at. We could board in 6 mana Chandra. I don't know how good this card is, though. I just kind of like walkers in general. Should we leyline them? No, right? Yeah, leyline seems super wrong. I don't think this is great, but I'll play a couple anyway. Cut a chalice, cut a Trinisphere maybe. Maybe I'm supposed to cut all the Trinispheres and bring in these Rebs. Hey, Dudley Dank, thanks for the 65 months. Yeah, you don't win the matchup by killing zombies, Gabtills. Ideally, you win the game before then. Not quite enough mana in that opener. So turn one Chalice on one would be awesome, but I don't want to burn the City of Traitors. What I want to do is turn two Blood Sun off this city and have that be awesome. Great. Still playing the Ancient Tomb over the city, even though Blood Sun's really good with City of Traitors, because I don't want, like that, or a Disenchant, or whatever. I don't want that to gunk me up too bad. Very timely Chalice on one here. Still with Forsen, apparently. Still with Forsen. Without that Ice Fang, we could have gone like Chandra down tick on Dried Arbor. Real clean like. What's gonna be an uptick now? And then hopefully we just get to untap and play this Chandra. That could be really sick, actually. So excited. I'm like unreasonably excited. I hope they don't have a counter spell for me. Oh yes, it resolved. How lucky. Yeah, I think that whole game came down to whether they had a counter for the 6-mana Chandra there or not. I think I'm gonna cut the Trinisphere on the draw. All their mana dorks and what. Chat's like, but this bait is so delicious. Why would I not eat this delicious bait? What else would I do? Two ley lines is terrible, right? It's tasty bait. It's super tasty. The fact that Blood Sun gets to draw a fucking card is so cool. I love that. And then Bloodstone works very well with the City of Traders, so we can keep on playing lands and ramping up here. Firing off some pressure here for the bridge. Not gonna be quite good enough. Because we can literally bridge and play a blank Chrome Mox. Why does that work with City of Traders? It says loses all abilities. City of Traders is the come to the play trigger is a ability. So it loses that. That's why. I win! I'm the winner! If we thought there was a chance of Spell Pierce, I didn't think there was, but if I thought there was a chance of Spell Pierce, we could have, like, coding the island, and if they float mana, we go to our second main phase or whatever. It felt like we had it locked up, though. Usually they play Flusterstorm instead of Pierce. And they didn't have the mana to hardcast Force Negation or anything. Do you keep an opener just off of Punishing Fire? I mean, the fast mana here is kind of nice. I guess I will, and then just, like, hope it's relevant against them. This deck's gotten a few trophies. Zivug. I first saw it when 3BNU was talking about it on Twitter. I almost don't even want to expose the Grove to Wasteland here. Just put, like, the Tumor. Attach Smashing. Oh no, we kept the wrong hand. We kept the wrong hand for this. Yeah, the Grove life gain activated ability is a mana ability, Zibwig. I have played against reanimator decks in this format that don't have answers to Ensnaring Bridge in the main deck. Won a really sick game that way a month or so ago. They could have put me on goblins instead of mono red prison. The reason I can rebuy the Punishing Fire here is the Order of Archon's ability. You discard a card, then they gain the life. If the order on the Archon's ability had them gain the life first, then it wouldn't work. Not that it super matters here. That seems pretty straightforward, mulligan-wise. The Tormod's Crypt is so that Karn can grab some fast disruption. We're not going to bring in the one of Tormod's Crypt. The blue has me a little bit worried about Show and Tell, the blue splash. We might get got by it and post-board. Could bring in Pyroblast, but I'm not sure how keen I am with the Trinispheres and Chalices on the Pyroblast. I'm not sure how keen I am on it. We still want our deck to work right. We still want at least walkers with the Jokulhaups.
I came from the mountain to was
I think this opener kind of rules. Sometimes you play the bridge on turn 1 just to get it down underneath, like, discard and stuff, but the Blood Sun makes our deck work a lot better. And it also, like, interferes with the opponent's fetches, potentially. Even if they have a discarded for the bridge, there's still, like, a Karn to go grab another one, too. Cantrip plus draw stem probably gets us our second land, we'll see. Yeah, hard to say no to drawing a card, right? Hard to say no to that. Yeah, folks confuse Blood Sun with Blood Moon quite often, huh? Omniscience? Okay. Not only are they show and tell, but it's main deck show and tell. The old reanimator show and tell omniscience stack of things. Aggressive music? Is that a joke? I think villagers are pretty chill. Fuck. No mana. They do have a fetch, though. Blood Sun doing work. Christmas Unicorn's aggressive. Christmas Unicorn on the third go is pretty aggressive. I think I'm discarding. Maybe I'm supposed to grab bridge there. I'm probably supposed to grab bridge there. They forced the last bridge. A flute tackler. Chat not enjoying this fine flautistry. Oh, I love that Jokulhaups got this, like, delicious old brown border. That looks really nice. A bagpipe? Oh, is it the Irish bagpipe? Sounds a little different than the Scottish one. According to their wiki page, they create a sound where the dominant solo instrument is the clarinet. Clarinet, friends. I was wrong too. They do also have the bagpipe listed on some of their tracks. And something called the Kaval, K-A-V-A-L, which is a chromatic end-blown flute played throughout the Balkans. This is what it looks like. Kind of sweet. Have I ever played in a band? Yeah, I was in some garage rock bands in the tail end of high school and the start of college. I had to drop out of one because the college work was just getting to be a bit much. I guess. I think this hand loses to what they're about, but I don't think you mulligan like leyline plus mana stuff. No, Ass Monkey. I could root around on MySpace and find some very old recordings, but it's not very good. We played a lot of shows. We would play, well, not a lot. We would like practice 2 days a week and then we would play a show on the weekends. And sometimes we would travel for that and play in like northern Minnesota or drive down to like central Wisconsin and stuff. And it was really easy for us to find shows because we were kids and we would play for like shit and anyone trying to throw on a rock concert for metalcore. Would happily like throw us on. It was fun. I didn't have three nights a week to give though. Most of us in the band were not that good. The reason I ended up with them was because I was like the only drummer in the area. With a double kick pedal. I was like the only one they knew that could actually like play the genre of music that they wanted to play. And metalcore and deathcore wasn't really for me at the time. I think we actually played something closer to deathcore than metalcore based on our vocalist. Our lead guitarist was actually good though. He's still playing in bands and such. Getting all rotted? Sure. So we got some options here. We can Blood Sun, we can Trinisphere, we can Chandra. I kind of like pitch Chandra. I might play this Trinisphere though. Make their cantrips shitty. No activating this Trinisphere now. Pay for exposure. Well, we never got paid for exposure. We would make enough to like pay for our gas and like whatever shitty fast food we ate that weekend. Or like if a member of the band's like amp broke or something, we would buy a new one out of the profits, quote unquote. The old 3-mana brainstorm, love it. Love that for you. How many groupies do we have? A non-zero number. The thing about that is, like, I think there's like a, this isn't really like a fucking earth-shattering thing or whatever, but there's some stigma against women expressing their sexuality without being labeled like some derogatory term, right? But then society has these like weird little loopholes where women are also like expected to throw themselves at sports stars or rock stars or what have you. So I think like even if the band's not very good, and we were not very good, it's still hard not to get laid if that's what you're looking for. Anyway, I'm thinking about Chandra or Karn. Karn just, like, getting bridge seems kind of good here. If they show and tell, we just, like, plop it into play. The cool thing about playing the Chandra is then we have that Chandra mana for future turns, but next turn we can always just play Blood Sun. I am shuffling some cards right now, yeah, sorry. Yeah, exactly, Hippo Fan. Let's not change the unequal part. Let's just, like, reshift it towards Twitch streamers. That's not a serious comment, of course. All right, Omniscience. Emrakul, the Promised End? Jeepers. Okay. Let's see what they do with my turn. Bridge is a static ability, That's why my opponent's Emrakul can't attack. It's got that blue can't attack text on it. I'll be calm as fire and rain. From the air. Diving to the sea of space. Yearning for eternal grace. No, there are sadly only four bridges in the deck, three in the main and one in the sideboard. Is Omniscience good against Jokulhaups? It's pretty good. We could potentially, like, cast the Jokulhaups with 3-mana floating. And then play another Trinosphere. And just hope they don't get to 3-mana. The line. They cannot deft. I am rising to the sky, like a spark in the night. You can never look at another player's sideboard? What if you're standing behind them while they're sideboarding? What about then? Yeah, or X-ray vision. What do you got? What do you got? Those X-ray specs. They played this Chandra, actually. I have way more mana to work with. If we draw mana off the top, we could potentially do the Jokulhaups into Trinisphere line. Karn could get a Great Furnace from the sideboard, so Seeming Spirit Guide would do it, or like one of the Soul Lands. Or Chrome Mox. I'm aware of the Null Rod, but Jokulhaups can kill the Null Rod. Yeah, tap that mountain. I wouldn't want to have that mana on my next turn. Yeah, my mana's short here. They could have swung into the Emmy, yeah. The Ensnaring Bridge was a 3-3, so it could have attacked, because there was three cards in hand. But they, I guess they wanted to do the Chandra down tick. Yeah, so playing the Jokulhaups is a little sketch, because we lose the Trinisphere, and then they untap with Omniscience. But our other lines are not that good, because they involve getting smacked with an Emrakul. Let me either like lose one of the Planeswalkers, or... Lattice isn't very good. They just attack the Karn with the Emrakul. Remember that the bridge is gone. Yeah, I also think we're gonna just board wipe and hope we don't die. We did have a bridge in the sideboard, that's what this bridge is. And then one more mana and we can play this fucking Trinisphere. Yes! Yes! I guess they could have a counter. Fuck. Well, we drew another Trinisphere, so we just need to fade another one. Alright. Oh, yes! My turn again! Sure, why not? Come on. Come on. Yes! Oh, that just gave me so much time. And now the Blood Sun can, like, keep them from cracking fetches, and they already had a bunch of lands in play. What was in their hand? No idea. Maybe Flusterstorm type cards? I don't know. More show and tells. Entombs, yeah, it could be reanimation stuff versus the ley line. That was a glorified Jokulhaups win. We needed it to kill their 13-13. Encoding turn off Omniscience. I don't think Omniscience cares about Karn. I think it's kind of good against Karn. Yeah, Omniscience is just a passive ability. It says you may cast spells from your hand without paying their mana costs. I don't think Karn turns off passive abilities, huh? Or it would turn itself off with the Lattice in play. What's the bait there, Jordan? Did I misspeak or something? Oh, Karn being opponents only? Sure. I think I can keep this on the play. It's not great, but we do have a turn 2 Trinisphere. What is Punishing Fire good against? Yeah, random stuff that slips through the cracks. Mana dorks and the like. If you were gonna cut them, then I think you'd play like Fury or something in their spot. Considered running out the Chromox so that it wasn't a Thoughtseize target, but if they Thoughtseize me and take Chromox here and we top deck like a Soul Land, then they get really browned. Scrubland into Thoughtseize is interesting. It's an interesting start. Dark Ritual? Oh no. Can considering imprinting the Jokulhaups. Feels wrong with them having a saga out. But also this Chandra doesn't answer their Sorin, whereas 5-mana Chandra can pressure it. Kind of tricky, hum. No land required. Bulldozer. Ritual. Interesting. Kind of what I was thinking was going to happen. Just needle out on Chandra, and the Sorin just gets to draw cards and win. Sorin's been seeing an interesting amount of play, huh? Saga is so broken, Jesus. Broken Jesus. I'm going to chill in the City of Traders for now, so we don't have a Sun handy. Interesting. They have another spirit? Damn. I was hoping for a little bit more life loss here. For the cheese. So gonna lose one of the smallpox. So they already been to their wasteland that we knew about. I don't know if I'm supposed to sack this grove or not. I'm not sure. I do not go foo. Someone's got some LD to point at me. Yeah, right, Dougie MacGyver? Me too. Yeah, Chandra not being able to hit opposing walkers when it could when it was first printed. Still a great card, but kind of a bummer for red mages, red mid-range players in Legacy and Modern, huh? My opponent's playing a smallpox deck. So they're not playing like any actual creatures themselves. That's the synergy. This isn't even good. It's like not even a little good. Chandra's supposed to cash in for that vampire token. Keep him at 5. I think we're dead. Sorin's unbeatable. Maybe we could have gotten a different planeswalker down. It was tricky choosing between pitching Jokulhaups or 5 mana Chandra. This all seems right. I don't hate 6 mana Chandra, but I don't think it's better than anything I'm currently playing. You could board in ley lines. I think that would be overboarding, though. I think the Punishing Fire stuff is good against the Lingering Souls and Nether Spirit and whatever, so we'll leave that in. I am certain that we have more Planeswalkers than them, Rufus, if you're asking. If you return P-Fire and Chromox it, the Chromox gets destroyed by Jokulhaups, right? What's the benefit? Just leaves... You end up in the same spot, only you don't have a Chromox in your hand. Even if it is blank. And the Punishing Fire is exiled. It costs a red mana to put the P-Fire back to your hand. It's not free. Man. Yes, I led with the Chromox here because I was thinking even if we get Thoughtseize turn one, we can still drop a 4-mana Walker on two. About that. Ooh, that's not bad. Turns off Wasteland, turns off Fetches. That's good with our own City of Traders. Oh, let's listen to some fucking witchcraft. Giving them the chance to sack it to the foundry in response to the P-Fire. Nah, we're gonna control their board, Chromatic Blast. So if we top deck a Planeswalker, they don't have like a 1-1 army. Could do the discard exile thing just to hit a land drop for the turn. I think we're like doing pretty okay as far as lands are concerned though. Yeah, this is not a bad spot, huh? Between the Blood Sun, the P-Fire nonsense. We'll take a plink off the Liliana here, why not? Now the Blood Sun turns off the Martial Arts fetch. I win! I'm the winner! They were just fucking off it. Whether we play the Karn or the Jokulhaups, they were off it. They were like, fuck this game. Six mana Chandra might be good against them. The thing about six mana Chandra is, they have that Nether Spirit card, right? And Chandra can exile permanently. Bring one in, cut like a chalice on the draw. That's all right. You thought that was game? That was game. It was not match though. Hand needs a Blood Sun, huh? To be in your school, your stubborn course. I have been thought seized. We need these thoughts, do we? Do we need these thoughts? I can spare a couple. Please, streamer, may we have some more thoughts? More? More? Certainly, have as much as you like. End of film. This Thoughtseize, huh? Deep in the tank. Finally grab Simeon Spirit Guide. Oh shit, what up? Hey, someone don't know God, thanks to the 48 months there. 4 years, approaching five, glad to be here. Hey, thanks, someone don't know God. Thanks, friend. Sharing that prime love. Saints are coming around the bend. Yes. Without you knowing, it beats your brain. Choices were made in the members. Yes. This is so cool. No. Oh, wait. They can't wasteland. Yes. The 3-mana Thoughtseize. No, my Chandra. I imagine they take that one, huh? All right. Come on, Planeswalker. I guess I'll play right in one of these. I guess Trinisphere could have protected Smashing from a Liliana uptick. If I had Chill on the redundant one. Usually you want to get your hand pretty empty in your Ensnaring Bridge deck, though. I just got Sinkhold. How dare ye. It's still a one, Taudist. Trinisphere doesn't change the casting cost of the card. Or are you talking about playing a Chalice when you have a Trinisphere in play? Anyway. Opponent trying to play LD over there. It's making my, like, string of however many lands in a row look kind of okay. No plays. Five cards in hand, no plays. Actually, I think we just do two damage here. Because we already played the land. Mana Mox Diamond. I am into it. Say me, Mr. Officer, what is it that you want from me? I'm just another brick in this fascist regime society. I stand naked and abused. I win the match. Sick, we're 3-0. The deck's kind of good. Really fun. It's really satisfying to just like play some obnoxious planeswalkers. And Blood Sun's a lot more fun than Blood Moon, I think. The fact that you get to draw a card and have some boss city of traders. We're gonna keep this. It would look better if we had a Chrome Mox, but. Hey, thanks, Emu is cool. Have a good rest. Have a good sleep. Maybe I'm supposed to lead on Ancient Tomb, because it's like less bad if the Ancient Tomb gets wasted. Basic Island, Basic Forest. Oh, they multi Oblivion. They only have three cards in hand. Oh, hello. Oh no. Oh, that's probably okay. We don't actually dump our hand very quickly here. is an issue. For Karn getting bridge. How about that suspend though, huh? Terrifying. Maybe we can get a transfer down or something. If they get their third land here, they can still just, like, pay for the rhinos. Ah, they can't crack that to Blood Sun! Yes! Come on, opponent, what are you gonna cast? Got another spirit guide over there. Yeah. Well, we barely won that. And they, like, mulled a four or something. Man, 6 mana Shauna down tick does not look good against rhinos, does it? I don't think we board it all here. Maybe like minus one P-Fire. P-Fire is really clunky, huh? Pyroblast? What do you want to counter with Pyroblast? This league is going great, yeah. 3-0 up a game. What's the Great Fortress on the sideboard for? Well, what this deck is doing is, like, resolving Jokulhaups while you have a Planeswalker out. And so the Great Fortress lets you rebuild. Lets you, like, grab a land after Jokulhaups has destroyed all the lands. I think I'm gonna send this hand back. Much better. A little bit off Kal-El. City of Traders is a very expensive card. And one issue with investing in this sort of deck is that, like, once you've, like, bought the City of Traders, you're kind of just, like, playing a similar deck. Like, they only really fit into the Chalice of the Void decks. Whereas if you invest in, like, dual lands, you can combine them in different ways and whatever. Like, helps you bridge into Legacy easier. I think we're going to see an answer to the Trinisphere this turn. Like a Brazen Borrower at end of turn to untap. Cascade, and that's what we're about to see. Brazen Borrower Hardcast, interesting. I wish I had that P-Fires here. Damn. Yeah, I was jamming that Chandra here because upticking feels so much better than downticking. You play this Chandra in downtick, and then they can... Flashing another Brazen Borrower to finish it off or something. Bleh. We're gonna lose this one. As much as I want to play the Blood Sun now, if they... Yeah, Cascade kills me anyway, right? Because it's going to be 8 damage if they violent on my end of turn. Let's just play the damn Blood Sun. I do not Mountain Brew. Bad sign. Yeah. No cascading, though. I don't think I can actually win from here. They hit me for 3 down to 5. I draw land. They hit me for 3 down to fucking 2. And then I'm dead. Yeah, bridge doesn't even do it. Yeah, Punishing Fire looked decent against that. Maybe better than 6 mana Chandra. Do have a lot of counters though. Pyros. Yeah, it's possible Pyros are good. I'm just not sure what you're cutting. Worried about Force of Vigor with this grip, with this opener. Considering holding onto the chalice. The issue is like double spirit guide and the cascade. Go, my little elite friend. We're gonna sandbag this Chrome Mox in case we get to Chandra ult here. Uh oh. Looks like a cascade turn, maybe. Just ice and a land a cycle. Ooh, hello.
How come all I see is black and white? It gets us down.
Sweet. Feels like Blood Sun was real fucking important in that game, huh? There's the 4-0. There's the 4-0. All 2-1s. And this last match is going to be it. I got to do some chores before I leave. Do some dishes so flies don't infest my house when I'm gone. Take the trash out, that sort of deal. Water the plants so they don't die. Pack, got to get all that shit in. My flight leaves roughly when I normally get to sleep, so that's going to be interesting. Means I'll be able to fall asleep on the plane to Germany. But it also means I'm going to be, like, stupid and tired at the airport. I hate that. Because I'm always worried I'm going to, like, fuck something up and miss my flight. Once I was so tired and dumb at an airport, I was just, like, sitting there waiting for my flight to board. And I missed the boarding. Sitting, staring at the gate. Just, like, fucking sitting there. And they called me over the loudspeaker. They're like, Caleb Durward, your flight is about to leave. And I'm sitting right in front of the lady. I'm like, let me on the plane. Wait. It's like right fucking there. They laughed. The flight folks got a kick out of it. Metal Festival, Sunset Bleach. I'm very excited, Mobius Stripteasing. Last night it hit me. I've been looking forward to this trip for a while, like ever since I booked it. And last night it hit me that I'm leaving tomorrow, or today, or whatever. And I was, like, laughing because I was so giddy. Giggling like an idiot by myself in my basement. Going to Berlin, Da Vinci. Desert Fest Berlin. Not as large as Desert Fest UK, but larger than Desert Fest New York and the other Desert Fests that are scattered around Europe. One of the oldest ones too, besides the UK one. I think it started like a year after. A currywurst? A currywurst sounds fucking awesome. I love German cooking. There's a lot of German descendants here in Wisconsin, where I live. So there's a lot of German-influenced cooking. Yeah, GG, Vizix. GG. What are the Desert Fests like? I don't know. I've never been to one. I don't know what the vibe is. My experience going to, like, Stoner Rock concerts and stuff has been pretty good. Just a lot of folks that like Black Sabbath and like bands that are inspired by Black Sabbath. Yeesh. I think we went to 5 here. Yeah. Should have been Chandra. Just keep like Chalice and Karn. Suppose. Thank you. think I'm not going to City of Traders. I'm just going to play a real boring Chalice on one on my turn two. Yeah, thanks for the kind words, folks. Hopefully it's a good trip. Looks like a Jeskai control here. There's something to play in the smashing this turn, and then pitch casting. Pitching to the guide to play the Karn, and then we'd be able to play the City of Traders the turn after. I think this is fine though. COVID restrictions? Yeah, I've looked at those. Vaccination and boosters, like fine to get into Berlin. To get back into the States, they have rapid tests at the airport. Not really ready to deal with the call to complete yet. Yeah, that was gonna get a bridge. That's what that was gonna grab. The clock hath begun. I love it when weird cards see play. Is that Blood Sun here? Is that the weird card? The Spirit Guide is here, so they don't have lethal. Interesting that Stoneforge isn't serving. It's basically bridge or bust. My opponent's got a lot of cards over there, and they might just have another counter handy. Jokulhaups? Jokulhaups would have been sweet. Actually, doesn't that not work against Calder Complete? I think we would just die. That's what I think. Indestructible germ, indestructible fucking seven thing. Do I want to cut Punishing Fire? Punishing Fire is good against their Stoneforge Mystic. Yeah, I don't know what I want to cut here. Maybe a Chalice, because they got clean answers. It'd be sweet if we came back and won this match. We've come back. We've come back in a lot of these. In the stream on a trophy. Sure. I'm gonna lead on smashing and then turn two transfer into Karin. When does Pyroblast see play? Outboarding Pyroblast against Show and Tell. Or mono blue opponents. Or against decks like. So, like in this matchup, Punishing Fire is good. But what if Punishing Fire is not good and I need to board things in? Pyroblast being able to, like, kill Murktide is kind of hot, too. So I might, like, let it against, against Delver. It runs into your own Chalices, but, like, if Chalice is resolved, you already have an edge against Delver. And then at that point, Pyroblast is one of your better cards. The surprise of nobody in the Tornosphere gets Forest. What did I bring in? Here? I just brought in a couple 6 mana Chandra. Nothing too fancy. Should we take an ass load of damage? For me. Disintegrates in your ocean of uncertain beliefs. The waves of your sea must be run by a complex without. They do get to see what we grab with Karin, yeah. Back to basics is a good reason to board in Pyroblast. Now that I've seen it. Nah, my thing. Just grab the coding again. Probably gonna chill on my mana until I can play this Chandra. Maybe not. We'll just try and kill that Teferi now. The paradox of this war. Instant speed ending. Love it. again. Oh my god. The shining light of the god. These fucking Teferis. Okay. We basically have this turn to rip a mana source and then actually resolve the Chandra. Well, that's a start. Dead. GG's. Well, we didn't trophy, but we gave it a mighty shot. Had a nice little 4-1 run there, and this deck was a lot of fun. I think I'll play this deck again in the future. Maybe the next time I do a legacy stream. The old Jokulhaups taking it down. Well, I'm not gonna be around for a week. That's a little scary to me. I'ma miss y'all. But let's raid somebody, huh? Let's share the love. Oh, let's raid let's raid a Hearthstone streamer. They seem like cool folk. Go and say hi. He'll get a kick out of it. Hey, good night, everybody. Much love, folks. I'll catch you next week.